10-0. Courtney Lyle and Holly McPeak with you. Two programs who know a lot of recent success. Wisconsin most recently winning a national championship in 2021. One of these teams will walk away with their first loss of the season. Izzy Ashburn to serve. Alexa Stuckey going back to Kennedy Martin, who could be the National Freshman of the Year.
I think she will be, the way that she has impacted this Florida team, but she's got a fantastic supporting cast around her.
What makes her special so early in her young career?
Well, at 6'6", she's got a lot of range, but the way she moves, the way she gets her feet to the ball.
She'll start off with a service error. But yeah, you will see Kennedy Martin, who swings on the right pen. She does a little bit of everything. She's got a great block, too.
And we haven't talked enough about Alexa Stuckey, the sophomore setter for Florida, who puts her freshmen in good positions to score.
Timmy Thomas-Ilara, one of the transfers coming in from Northwestern. A.C. Fitzpatrick wanted a touch, and she will get it. She's coming off a career-high 22 kills.
The entire Wisconsin team telling their head coach, Kelly Sheffield, they did not touch that ball.
And Kelly Sheffield is going to pull the green challenge card. So for the first time early on in this match today, we will have a challenge. Each team gets two challenges. As long as you're correct in your challenge, you get to keep it.
One of the biggest challenges playing against this Wisconsin team is their size at the net. They've got gigantic players who put so much pressure on their opponents at the net.
So the original call was a touch on this ball. Look for any fingers moving on that Wisconsin block as they press.
It's interesting. I do not see any finger movement in that replay. I saw it right in front of us, and I didn't see a touch.
Again, it has to be obvious for them to overturn this because the call, original call, was that there was a touch on this ball and the point went to Florida.
And usually you would see a finger bend back or something in that replay.
There's a great look.
It looks like it went right in between the seam.
Yeah, I think that shows no touch.
AC Fitzpatrick trying to go high and flat off those high hands.
Joseph Gustafson is our R2, our down official. He will let us know what the call is. Patty Rolfe up in the R1 position, one of the best in the business. No touch on that ball. The ball was hit out, and so the point goes to Wisconsin. Kelly Sheffield will keep his challenge. Incredible what he has done, taking over Wisconsin. Four straight Big Ten championships. Not to mention the national championship in 2021. A.C. Fitzpatrick will try it again.
The libero for Florida put up a fantastic pass, and then Alexa Stuckey gets her left side player, A.C. Fitzpatrick, isolated on the outside, one-on-one, middle blocker late to close, and that's advantage hitter for Florida.
Emily Canaan, one of the great DSs for Florida. That's one of their strengths, their back row play, and a long on the serve.
Mary Wise always has a big front row, and then she calls her defensive specialists her littles, and they're very good at their job.
Yeah, Kelly Sheffield, Wisconsin's coach, said, you know, facing Florida is always tough. They've got a great setter, a great libero, and they have littles for days. Point Wisconsin.
Tough serve right there, overpass, and Caroline Crawford able to score an easy one.
Julia Orzel stepping back once again for Wisconsin. She is new to that libero jersey in years past. She's a junior now. We've seen her play in that outside hitter position. And there's Anna Dixon, the transfer from Missouri.
And that's been a huge addition for Florida. Anna Dixon volunteered to play middle, but she has hit pin all her life. And in this rotation where Florida only has two hitters in the front row, she's able to hit a second tempo ball.
Now, this is a grad transfer who over the summer went to the coaching staff and said, I think it can help you better in the middle. And that's going to be, the setter is back row because Wisconsin runs a 6-2 offense.
Wisconsin runs a 6-2 offense, so they always have three hitters in the front row. That ball passed too tight, and she's called for a back row violation.
Yeah, Izzy Ashburn is the setter out there now. MJ Hamill is the other setter that Wisconsin will use. This one bumped over to Devin Robinson. Stuckey sends it back. Caroline Crawford with the bump to Sarah Franklin. Devin Robinson.
Double contact called for Wisconsin, and Florida scores the point.
Holly, it is loud inside the O-Dome today. We are expecting could break an attendance record here at Florida.
I'm seeing people all the way up in the rafters, so I'm thinking they're going to definitely break that record. Wow, service pressure from Florida, and two players from Wisconsin run into each other on that one.
It's a 4-0 run for the Gators.
This is a special Florida Gator team. You can feel the energy. They're young, they're hungry. They bought in to what their coaching staff has been teaching them since January.
And an ace for Anna Dixon. Keep it going.
Talk about leadership. Anna Dixon. Sacrifice, playing out of position, learning a new position, a position in the middle that she hasn't played since seventh grade, because she knew that would help this Florida Gator team.
Holly, how many people are volunteering to play middle?
Nobody.
Yeah, it's not easy. It's
a very difficult position. And you're facing off against players that are 6'9" on the other side of the net.
Wisconsin out of system. Stuckey pushing it to Sophia Victoria. Ashburn calling on Sarah Franklin down the line. Dug up by Dixon. Kennedy Martin out of the back row. And there's the Wisconsin block. Caroline Crawford in the middle working hard.
And Sarah Franklin came in from the left side. And that's something Kelly Sheffield said. This is really important. Our left side needs to decide to stay or pull off. But there, she helps on the block, knowing where Kennedy Martin likes to attack out of the back row.
Sarah Franklin started her career at Michigan State. She's now in her second season playing at Wisconsin. MJ Hamill, the other setter in this 6-2 offense, has rotated in for the Badgers. They'll try Martin again, trying to avoid that block goes long.
And that's one of the problems. The challenge is when you play a team like Wisconsin, they're huge at the net. Kennedy Martin's a strong attacker. She's long as well, but that puts a lot of pressure on them.
We were talking to Mary Wise, Florida's head coach, about the size of Wisconsin. They did play Stanford, who does have some similar size, but obviously Wisconsin, a bigger team.
Yeah, you have to find ways to score, and obviously that first contact to run your offense and create some holes in the block creates opportunities. Sophia Victoria able to score there because the middle blocker laid to press.
You saw a glimpse of what Mary Wise loved when she recruited Sophia Victoria, was her blur of an arm. And Mary Wise, 33 seasons as the head coach of the Florida Gators. 8 national semifinal appearances, a 3-time National Coach of the Year. Wisconsin wanting 4 touches, Anna Schmreck in the middle, standing at 6'9".
And Anna Schmreck is so versatile, the number 14 in red. One thing she can do is hit those quicks out of the middle, but she lines up as opposite on the right side. So she's got the versatility to hit the high set, but at 6'9", her hitting percentage is unstoppable in the middle.
How much does that stress the block? Whether she's in the middle or she's moving over to the right pin, you gotta guess.
Yeah, and you have to respect her in the middle, and that creates openings on the pins.
Kennedy Martin going off the block. Thomas Ilaria with the dig. Sarah Franklin out of the back row. And that goes over. Last touch by Florida. It'll be a point for Wisconsin. We're tied at 8.
But pinball dig by Florida. Almost able to get that over the net. They are touching so many balls defensively.
Playing to 25 here in the opening set. It is the best of 5. Both teams undefeated.
Wisconsin trying to stay aggressive from the service line, but right now I think Florida is putting more pressure on Wisconsin with their serve than Wisconsin is towards Florida.
Here's Trinity Adams. Hamill using Franklin with a roll shot. Alexis Stuckey setting up Fitzpatrick. Timmy Thomas, Alaria, a big addition for Wisconsin this season. That ties it at 9.
And I like where she's swinging down the line at the setter, Alexa Stuckey. Even if she digs it, somebody else has to step in and set.
Wisconsin trying to get their 5th ranked win of the season. For Florida, a win today would be their first win over the number one team since 2017 when they beat Texas. Stuckey getting tricky.
Alexa Stuckey came in last year as a freshman and was an impact player for this Florida team. In my opinion, one of the best setters in the country, and she has built on that. Starts with a good first contact that sets her up for that little set over on 2.
Stuckey, a third team All-American last year. She was the SEC Freshman of the Year. She digs up Anna Schmreck. Fitzpatrick on the roll. MJ Hamill laying out for it. Free ball back to the Gators. Anna Dixon out of the middle. Another great dig for Wisconsin. Scrappy play on both sides. Fitzpatrick, no! Anna Schmreck, feel it.
Love the extended rally. Such good defense on both sides of the net, but 6'9" Schmreck, she is putting up a wall and setting up a really nice block. AC Fitzpatrick has her work cut out for her today.
Anna Schmreck, a junior out of Ontario. The tallest player in Wisconsin history at 6'9". Kennedy Martin tooling the block. Just her second kill.
Well, I feel like Wisconsin had a plan to slow her down, and they've had hands in good positions, but Kennedy Martin's still able to score off the outside hands of the blocker.
Now you better have a plan to slow her down. She's averaging 4.6 kills per set. That is a huge number.
And 5th in the country.
It's going to be tight. Carter Booth punches it over. Fitzpatrick. Ashburn going to Robinson. Thomas Alaria.
Carter Booth, the middle blocker for Wisconsin, called for going over the net. The setter is allowed to go up and set that ball, and Alexa Stuckey was on her side of the net.
Here's Kennedy Martin. Devin Robinson coming off of 1 foot. Fitzpatrick. Kennedy Martin out of the back row.
Florida has established their pins and they're able to isolate the middle attack here. Watch Kennedy Martin come out of the back row. Only one blocker in front of her, and she goes crossbody at that right back defender with success.
Nice serve too. It just dropped over the net. Thomas Alaria with the swing. Fitzpatrick will tip over the Wisconsin block. Look at Izzy Ashburn. Anna Dixon. And there you see they use her on the right side.
The defense for Florida right now, they're able to put themselves in positions to score. They're going left side, middle, right, trying to stress that big block for Wisconsin.
It's a 4-0 run for the Gators. And that serve hits the antenna, so it's out of play. Point for Wisconsin. Maybe that helps the Badgers get back on track.
Florida hitting 208 and Wisconsin hitting 167. Well below their season averages.
Sage Damrow is going to check in. One of the freshmen for Wisconsin actually played club volleyball with Kennedy Martin of Florida, and Sage's dad was their head coach. Kennedy Martin with the handset to Fitzpatrick. No touch, point Wisconsin.
AC Fitzpatrick, she had Anna Schmreck, the 6'9 blocker in front of her. Now she's got Carter Booth at 6'7". I mean, she cannot catch a break.
What does she have to do with a block that size in front of her?
Well, tooling, going off flat off the hands, going out off the outside hand. Not easy, especially when it's a well-formed block.
So the service error will make Florida the first team to 15 points. We step aside, a Heckers up 15-12 here in the opening set. Emily Canaan getting set to serve for Florida. Ashburn will go to Carter Booth in the middle. Wow.
That is one area for Wisconsin where they've really improved that connection between setter and middle blocker. Last year, he said, "What? It was an adventure." But this year, look at the connection. Not easy to set someone 6-7 because they've got to get it high enough and quick enough. But there, the connection, perfect.
Kelly Sheffield calls Carter Booth a force of nature with how she impacts the game. Point for Florida.
Front row setter Alexis Stuckey is very offensive-minded, especially when there's only two hitters in the front row. There, Stuckey and Okamura return the favor, blocking at the net. They got very predictable. I feel like Florida's serving strategically to get that predictable offense off to that left pin, just going line to line at the left side players.
Let's see if Wisconsin can adjust to that. Devin Robinson. Coming back. Nice placement. They'll swipe it down. Point for the Badgers.
Devin Robinson, number 10 for Wisconsin, can dominate a match, so they need to make sure that they're passing the ball well enough to keep her in system.
She was a third-team All-American, her second All-American honor last season. Second on the team with a 318 hitting percentage last year. She's up that this year, hitting 335. Nadie Okamura coming off of 1 foot.
It starts from the pass, and right now Florida winning that serve and pass game, getting that ball right in Alexis Stuckey's hand and then high over the top.
Do you think that's helped Kennedy Martin, the freshman coming in, to have a great setter like that?
Oh, it's helped her a lot. I mean, a great setter knows how to put her hitters in locations where they can score. And you see the rhythm, the tempo. She runs a fantastic offense.
She's got Florida hitting 293 on the season. That's third in the SEC, 13th in the nation. Gators hitting 214 in this match, but Wisconsin hitting 182. And Nadie Okamura and Kennedy Martin teaming up.
Florida is serving this ball short into traffic to disrupt the offensive rhythm and the pass. And now they go high predictable to the left pin, and Florida able to score with the block.
Largest lead for the Gators today. Sarah Franklin cutting that angle, but no, too wide.
Wisconsin again out of system. That set's coming from way off the net, and Florida has a well-formed block and defense in front of her.
And Wisconsin will take its second and final timeout of this set as Florida up 20-14. Well, tomorrow we'll have two Monday Night Football matchups for you. Saints against the Panthers at a special start time of 7 Eastern on ESPN and ESPN Deportes. And then the Browns take on rival Steelers at 8 Eastern on ABC and ESPN.
On average, it's 324. So you can see those numbers that Florida is holding Wisconsin to. That's why they're having success as a team.
Gators on a 3-0 run, 5 points away from taking the opening set.
This is a rotation for Wisconsin. Anna Smrex in the front row. They want to use her on that quick. So look at her attack out of the middle. High percentage play if they can pass the ball.
Smrex, number 14 in red for Wisconsin. Hamill going to Smrex in the middle. Sends Florida scrambling. Victoria Sarah Franklin. The next wing wide, point Wisconsin.
Missed opportunity for Florida, but they were able to stop Smrek twice in that rally and had a swing to score the point, just missing wide.
Sarah Franklin on the serve for the Badgers. Nadie Ogamore in the middle. Thomas Ilaria readjusts, dug by McKissick. McKissick digs her again. Anna Smrek on the right pin. It hit the antenna after touching the Wisconsin block, so it's a point for Florida.
Florida defensively so disciplined with their hands on the touches on the block. Here, Kennedy Martin goes off the right hand of Smrek, and it hits the antenna.
Kelly Sheffield was up asking Anna Smrek if she touched that first. That is something you could challenge.
Service pressure from Florida really creating problems for Wisconsin. Those passes way off the net and then the double contact on the set.
Florida 3 points away from taking the opening set. And Smrek trying to establish that connection in the middle.
Well, but Florida has two blockers there on that one. They know they want to get Anna Smrek the ball. That ball was set a little bit low and just a misconnection between setter and hitter.
It's coming over. Nadie Ogamore gives set point to the Gators.
Florida really putting a lot of pressure. That one goes to Yulia Orzel, the libero for Wisconsin, who is a very consistent passer, but struggling right now, and then the easy kill at the net.
Florida.
In them out, pass with fewer passers. Try something to clean up and control that first contact so they can use their weapons. Nobody for Wisconsin has more than one kill.
Both teams 8-0. That will change for someone today, being perfect. And there's that hitting percentage we talked about. Wisconsin hitting zero and Florida winning in pretty much every category. Hitting 194, not a great hit percentage, but their serving was so tough that it worked out for them. They'll immediately go to Carter Booth in the middle. Timmy Thomas, Ilaria, and the miss hit. Point for Florida.
Florida really good at extending the rally. They might not end the rally with a block, but it causes and puts more pressure on Wisconsin to have to try and score again.
Devin Robinson looking solid off of 1 foot.
And Devin Robinson lines up as a right sider, but she can go off 1 foot. She can hit the quick tempos. Another versatile attacker for Wisconsin.
This Wisconsin team has played in some really tough matches. They are 4-0 against ranked opponents this year, and they've been tested, and we've seen them really have to grind it out to pick up wins. You can never count them out.
Well, I think those are always learning experiences. When your back's against the wall, when you're not playing your best volleyball, how can you find a way to win? And when we talked to Dave Booz for Florida, he said, guess what? We're finding ways to win in different situations. So they're trying to figure it out as well.
Izzy Ashburn going to Carter Booth. She makes it work. What an addition Carter Booth has been. The transfer from Minnesota, came out of high school as the number 14 overall recruit, was the Colorado Gatorade Player of the Year. Her dad, Calvin, played basketball at Penn State and then 10 years in the NBA. Of course, the GM of the Denver Nuggets.
And Kelly Sheffield says, look, Carter Booth wants to be great. She does the work.
Yeah, we asked him today, as there's a hitting error by Sophia Victoria, you know, how does she fit into the culture piece? And he said it was seamless.
Seamless. She found her people. She loves this Wisconsin group, and she wants to be better. This Wisconsin staff is pushing her every day.
Service error. Yulia Orzel goes long. Anna Dixon steps back. Florida has had nice success with Anna Dixon behind the service line. And they'll get a point off of Anna Dixon's serve thanks to the swing from Sophia Victoria.
And Alexis Stuckey creates some space for her hitter to score on the left side. Look at this. Good push out. The middle blocker stays with the middle attacker, and that's where Alexis Stuckey has success.
That one hits the tape and bounces back. Service error on Florida.
Alexis Stuckey, the setter for Florida, in the front row right now. So she's got two front row attackers on the left, and she's got Kennedy Martin available out of the back row.
And remember, that's a different system than the one Wisconsin is running. For Wisconsin, the setter will always be in the back row, meaning she always has three attackers in the front. Nady Okamore, all right.
When we watched serve and pass for Florida earlier, they were doing a lot of tipping into the middle of the court. They called it the donut, and I've seen two or three balls already drop for Florida today.
Anna Smrek!
That is the set connection you want between setter and middle blocker. She buries that. This is what you call a three set in the gap, right between the blockers, and you see her do her work. Wow.
Tooling the block is Kennedy Martin, kill number five.
Quick tempo, that's something Florida started using in January, a quicker offense to speed things up. They've got the setter to do so, and you see a payoff for Kennedy Martin because the blocker is late to close from middle to right side.
We were talking to associate head coach Dave Booz about that, and he said they were kind of surprised. Kennedy Martin was so good in the faster offense, pretty much off from the start in the spring.
Yeah, it's a big adjustment for a lot of players, but it's 6 foot six, her timing, her footwork, and her rhythm with the setter was fantastic.
What is it about Alexis Stuckey that allows them to run that faster offense?
The hands, the location, the everything she does with the ball in her hands.
Martin. Thomas Ilaria. AC Fitzpatrick, again, struggling to get around that Wisconsin block. And Anna Smrek forcing it through.
Anna Smrek on the right side that time. Florida lost sight of the ball. It was just right over their block, but couldn't find it.
Oh, OKAC. That's the swing she's been looking for.
This is what makes Alexis Stuckey special. That ball is off the net. Look at Alexis Stuckey get her feet there and push a tempo ball to create an opening down that line for AC Fitzpatrick. That's impressive.
Service error, Ellie McKissick.
Izzy Ashburn, the best server on this Wisconsin team.
It just became their career aces leader. Timmy with some heat behind it.
Tembi Thomas-Ilara able to score on that one. Transition ball. See this overhand dig, and then Yulia Orzel, the libero for Wisconsin, gets up, puts up that nice apex ball for Tembi Thomas-Ilara to score for Wisconsin.
Just her second kill. She's trying to dig herself out of hitting negative. Wisconsin hitting better in this set, 333. Devin Robinson, dug up by Trinity Adams, but nobody got there.
Alexis Stuckey immediately turns her team, says, that's my ball, because the setter has to get the second ball in, yes, unless she screams help.
First time Wisconsin has led by three today. Florida took the opening set 25-15. Kennedy Martin.
Pretty good defensive touch at the net by Wisconsin, but communication breakdown in the backcourt.
Kennedy Martin, six kills, hitting over 300. It's her first kill in this set. Coming off 25 kills against Florida State, that was a very tough match. Earlier in the week for this Florida Gators team, went to five and they won the fifth set 16-14. Thomas-Ilara. Anna Dixon going behind the setter.
Another well-located set by Alexis Stuckey in transition, putting her teammate in there, Dixon, in a fantastic location to score. Turning those digs into points, that's what Florida's doing better than Wisconsin.
That one grazes the tape. They'll run Carter Booth in the middle. AC Fitzpatrick looking for the corner pocket. 3-0 run for the Gators.
Look at the players for Florida fight for position. And then knowing where to go, AC Fitzpatrick has found those tools, ways to score. That's something that she's really focused on. She's an undersized left side player, but finding ways to score and knowing what's open defensively.
And the Florida coaching staff talked to us about how this faster offense has helped her too, being undersized.
Wisconsin, again, out of system, in serve receive, unable to take control of that first contact.
Four straight for Florida. Tip by Thomas-Ilara. Martin out of the back row will tip. Yulia Orzel with the pancake, but Wisconsin can't get it up.
Kennedy Martin for Florida. She knows what's open when she's attacking that Vic, that back row quick set. But the pancake from Yulia Orzel has to be put up by the rest of her teammates. They all watch that drop.
And the service error as it goes long. That ends a 5-0 run by Florida.
Wisconsin now has Sarah Franklin in the front row.
Sage Damrow back in. Made her debut in their last match against Marquette. And Trinity Adams, a tough first contact. It's going to result in a free ball back to the Badgers. Devin Robinson. Adams digs it. Fitzpatrick. Ellie McKissick, how did she get underneath that? And the bump set, it's just off target. That's a good point for Florida. What a rally.
If you just watch the way the team in blue is playing defense, the way they move as a unit, you have to just be impressed. They move and they see what's happening, the great eye work at the net and great eye work in the backcourt as well.
Ace! Emily Canaan!
Laser beam serve down the line, pinning the passer in a tough spot.
Third ace for Florida.
Florida already has three aces so far.
Stuckey trying to put it back, but Carter Booth is going to win that battle.
This is the rotation where Alexis Stuckey's in the front row for Florida. She can attack the ball, but she leaves Dixon on the right pin so she can set Kennedy Martin out of the back row in the middle. So she's got three dangerous attackers.
She'll give it up to Dixon. Devin Robinson will try the right side with a little heat behind it.
Devin Robinson is hitting 360 on the season. You want to get her the ball as much as possible. She can dominate a match, but look at this in transition. Push to the right side, over the top, down the line.
And she's hitting 444 in this match with four kills to lead the Badgers. Oh, Alexis Stuckey is down. They're checking her right leg right now.
Looks like right knee. Yeah.
She went up to throw this ball down.
Going back, I believe it was a tight pass. She shoves it down really sharp and landed wrong.
So they're going to take her back to the Florida locker room. And goodness, you hate to see that. I mean, a player that makes this Florida team go. So Kennedy Muff will come in. She has played in two sets this season. Number 14 in blue. And a misconnection on the Florida side. Wisconsin is the first to 15. But devastating news, Alexis Stuckey helped off the court here in Gainesville. you're just joining us, Florida's All-American setter Alexis Stuckey came down and has what looks like a right leg injury. She was helped off the court. So Kennedy Muff, a graduate student, has come in. She's only played in two sets this season. And Sophia Victoria is going to get the kill off the set from Muff.
I watched Muff setting the ball earlier today. She was getting reps and Stuckey was passing. And her delivery is really nice. She runs at good pace.
Florida took the first set 25-15. And again, it's Sophia Victoria.
Florida did a really nice job scouting the Wisconsin defense. They know that that deep line shot is available. Both outside hitters for Florida have used that.
Anna Dixon serving. And it's an ace for Dixon. Four aces now for the Gators.
The left side attackers for Wisconsin are pinched over on the line. And Florida is attacking the seam between the DS and that left side hitter.
Timeout, Wisconsin, their first of the set as Florida up 17-15. A 3-0 run for the Gators. And we told you about Kennedy Martin. She may be the front runner for the National Freshman of.
And that means put some pressure on the Florida offense and slow them down. They have not been able to do that. And they also need to shore up their serve receive, their passing, their communication.
So can Wisconsin stop this 3-0 run by the Gators out of the timeout? And Muff trying to dump it over, and it goes into the net.
I like the idea. Kennedy Martin shifting over, digging that deep line ball. Florida with a transition opportunity, but missed there. This is a stack left. Muff is in the front row. A little bit smaller than Stuckey.
Muff back to Nadie Okemor, and she finds a way to put a point on the board.
Nothing better than having a confident setter who can step in this type of situation and just run the offense. Good one-on-one, and then the middle is wide open.
Sarah Franklin going after it. CeCe Crawford on the right side.
That time, taking some pressure off Sarah Franklin on the left side, pushing it to the right, and Crawford able to score. Wisconsin's offensive numbers improving.
And MJ Hamill is over talking to Patty Rolfe, our up official.
Not sure if they're complaining about the lights that are being shined towards the court.
Yeah, the student section had their cell phone lights up, and I think, yeah, that's not allowed. So Wisconsin was letting Patty Rolfe, the up official, know, and they've been asked to turn those off. Wisconsin facing the student section of Florida right now. And that's a double contact on Wisconsin.
Muff putting a pretty ball to the left pin for Kennedy Martin, who goes over the top to the middle. Wisconsin's digging it, but can't do much with it.
Oh, Martin having to readjust her approach. MJ Hamill to Anna Smrek. Smrek through the block, and Anna Smrek with her fourth kill.
And I like how Anna Smrek, instead of passing, it just went up and attacked that ball, waving everybody else off. Good aggressive play. She knows her team needs her to be aggressive. Kennedy Martin hitting that ball away from the line defender with pace. Her control offensively, and the spots that she's picking are really difficult to defend.
That's eight kills now for Martin, a 400 hitting percentage. And there's some moisture on the Wisconsin side of the floor, so they'll take a moment to wipe that up.
We talk about Kennedy Martin's numbers. We know that Wisconsin's trying to stop her, and she's still putting up those kinds of numbers.
Well, Kelly Sheffield talked to us about that. Like, there is film now. There's a lot of film on Kennedy Martin now. It's not a secret what she's going to do. But what's most impressive is she's still doing it. Teams are having trouble stopping her. And the block, too.
Wisconsin out of system, the block moves in. Dixon and Martin, look at their eye work. They come in, but they move back out, and Kennedy Martin sets up that block perfectly for Florida Gators.
Wisconsin calls timeout. It's second and final timeout of this set. Florida up 21 to 18, going to 25. Tuesday. We know we're going to have a great crowd come December right here in the Sunshine State in Tampa for the national championship, which will be on ABC for the first time this year. Anna Smrek on the right side through the Florida block.
That's her fifth kill on 12 swings. She has been very effective for Wisconsin.
Sarah Franklin got that ball up. Free ball back to Florida. Muff going to the middle with Anna. Dixon. Thomas Ilaria. Just power. Straight power. Kennedy Martin. Pretty swing.
Wisconsin making all sorts of efforts to keep the ball alive. This roll shot. Look at Sarah Franklin slide under that ball to keep it alive. But Florida able to score in transition. Kennedy Martin on that right pin.
That puts Martin at 9 kills to lead all hitters in this match. She also has 4 digs and 3 blocks.
That's a strong stat line. A
pretty strong stat line indeed. Carter Booth challenged by Dixon. Trinity Adams will bump set AC Fitzpatrick. Robinson, long point Gators.
Incredible by Florida, the way they're playing defense, the way they're staying in rallies and being very disciplined.
Gators 2 points away from taking set 2. Shoved back on the Florida side by Carter Booth.
Carter Booth, good eye work by her to throw that down. Florida continues to push that pace to the left side pin to open up opportunities. That one a little bit low.
Devin Robinson and Carter Booth.
This is a rotation for Florida where they've got a setter front row. They've got a left side and a right side pin. Even though this ball's fast enough to create a seam, Devin Robinson solo block for Wisconsin.
When you face Wisconsin, you know you're going to see their size. That's a great demonstration of it right there. We wanted to put in perspective how tall these players are. Anna Smrek is at 6'9". That's the same height as LeBron James. Carter Booth, who was just in on that block with Devin Robinson, 6'7", just like Jimmy Butler.
So much pressure, but Florida has found ways to score.
And what do you have to do when you're facing such a team that has that height advantage and has a solid block?
One, you have to serve tough, take their offense away from them, and then beat them with speed, those attacking those gaps when you can get one-on-one, and Florida's been able to do that.
Gators need 2 points to take this set. If you're just tuning in, earlier here in set two, unfortunately, Alexis Stuckey, the All-American and reigning SEC Freshman of the Year setter for the Florida Gators, went down with a right leg injury. She was helped off of the court and back to in set number one and lost by 10.
Florida has slid their hitters to the left side before they split them left and right.
So one of our referees is talking to one of the photographers who's sitting on the sideline opposite the Florida bench.
I don't think he's allowed to be using a tripod right next to the court.
Dixon dug up down the line by Damrow. And they're going to call a net violation on Florida.
Wow, I did not see a net violation there.
This is something that Mary Wise could challenge, and she will grab the green challenge card.
I like that challenge.
Yeah, I didn't see a net either, but let's take another look.
Muff turns and battles here.
Oop, yep.
Well, there's a reason why she's one of the best referees in the country.
That's right. Don't be questioning Patty Rolfe.
I apologize.
I did it too. Sorry, Patty.
Either way for Florida, win or lose, it slows things down, gives them a second to connect with their coaching staff, their defensive assignments.
So the call is confirmed. There was a net violation. You could see it there. Rio run now for Wisconsin. Service error, set point Gators.
And that's a break for Florida. They were in a rotation where they were struggling to get out, but the missed serve gives Florida set point.
Emily Canaan. Izzy Ashburn to Carter Booth behind her. Florida wins the first two sets against number one Wisconsin.
Incredible response from this floor.
This set in order to extend the match.
Prior to this match, we thought the experience and all the weapons for Wisconsin might give them the advantage, but I'll tell you, the way Florida is playing, they have taken charge.
Can they keep that up without their All-American setter? Alexis Stuckey going down in the second set. Kennedy Muff has taken over.
That ball just wide by Martin.
Kennedy Martin, 9 kills in this match. We've seen, though, how scrappy Wisconsin can be. They have been tested this season, and somehow they always find a way to respond. That's why they're the number one team in the nation. AC Fitzpatrick.
Perfect set. Isolation on the left side. You know a setter's doing her job when she's able to isolate her left pin hitter. Even though it's Anna Smrek in front of her at 6'9", AC Fitzpatrick still able to score.
Orzel, nice first contact. Sarah Franklin, it's in. They need her to get going.
They certainly do, to get out of those negative numbers in end rallies for Wisconsin. This pass a little bit off the net, but Ashburn able to push the tempo to the left side.
Anna Dixon down the line, dug up by Orgel. And there's going to be a net violation on Florida. Timmy Thomas, Ilara with a nice swing. Tipped back over by CeCe Crawford. Anna Smrek. Muff to Fitzpatrick. Look at her work that line shot.
AC Fitzpatrick, wow. But Trinity Adams had two really good digs to set her up for that kill-in transition, and Muff continues to deliver.
AC Fitzpatrick coming off a career-high 22 kills against Florida State earlier this week. Anna Spreck making it work.
Wisconsin handling the serve receive, so they're able to run that quick attack to Anna Spreck.
That has given them problems early in this match, serve receive, and trying to get that good pass off. Muff can't get there. Tough first contact by Emily Canaan, and it's a point for Wisconsin.
And Crawford attacking down that line. Setter is front row. She's got two attackers left and right. Dixon on the right, Victoria on the left, and then Kennedy Martin out of the back row.
Sophia Victoria, Anna Smrek.
Anna Smrek read that play perfectly, got in front of her hitter, and was way over the net defensively for Wisconsin. Watch 14 in red on the right side of your screen. Get in front. She takes all of that. That is a solo block.
Service error for CeCe Crawford, but we're seeing more of that Wisconsin team we've been used to seeing. They look a little more comfortable here in set three.
And it starts with their defense. If they can slow this Florida offense down, that will help create some more opportunities to score.
You know, Kelly Sheffield told us he likes how they're finishing matches. Somehow they flip the switch and they play a little bit more free when their backs are against the wall, and that's certainly the case here down two sets.
And you want a veteran team like Wisconsin to respond like that. This Florida team has come out swinging. How will Wisconsin respond? And they are in this third set, they've been better.
So Alexa Stuckey is back over on the Florida bench with a pretty large brace on her right leg and on crutches. Again, she went down in set number two. And a net violation is Kennedy Muff going into the net. Point Badgers. Timeout Florida. Wisconsin up 8-3. So we step aside. The Badgers coming back, trying to keep that perfect record. Florida has to call a timeout as Wisconsin, Holly hitting 800 in set three.
And holding Florida to negative 143. That ball is up.
What a hustle from Yulia Orzel. New to this libero role, came into Wisconsin as an outside hitter.
And she's been starting at that left side pin the last couple of years, but she's kind of got that calming effect. She's been on the court. Look at her. It's her second layout to keep the ball alive from that left back defensive position.
Originally from Poland before coming to Wisconsin.
And that's a hard adjustment, going from an offensive attacker to only playing defense and in serve receive. So she's trying to get acclimated to that. You don't get that high of being able to kill the ball.
Izzy Ashburn working with Devin Robinson, who looks solid on the slide.
Ashburn delivering a beautiful slide set, and Robinson so good off one foot. Wisconsin's starting to look like that dangerous offense that we're used to seeing from them.
Yeah, a team that hits 311 on the season. That's sixth in the nation, first in the Big Ten. Hitting 162 for the match, but in this set, hitting 857. And that'll be four contacts.
Now Wisconsin able to get Florida out of system. We're seeing plays where they're struggling, and that's because of the tough serve.
Hey, look at the hitting percentage. Wisconsin hit zero in set number one. That was so shocking to see.
300 points lower than their season average, and that's because of the serving and the defense from Florida.
Kennedy Martin saves it, and Ellie McKissick. We're going to call a double contact on Florida.
Kennedy Martin got her back against that referee stand, able to save it.
Gulje Guchkaten, excuse me. She has donned the libero jersey a lot for Wisconsin, was the main libero last season. Gigi working in a defensive specialist role this year. Wow, that looks good. Carter Booth.
Ashburn to Booth. Pretty attack out of the middle. That's a three set where you spread it, and it puts so much pressure on the middle block. Look, it's right between the two blockers for Florida.
Carter Booth with four kills, four blocks also. Robinson off hands.
When Robinson's able to score on that right side, she is hard to stop, and Florida has not been able to stop her in this third set.
A 5-0 run for Wisconsin. They are up 10. Backs against the wall after dropping the first two sets. Kennedy Martin.
Kennedy Martin shows she can run all the tempos. That time a quick tempo out of the middle. Good pass here. You see them go double quick. One out of the middle, one to the right, and Kennedy Martin able to score.
We have seen her swing on the right pin, the left pin, the middle now, and the back row.
She's dangerous from everywhere.
10 kills for her. She continues that streak of double-figure kills in every match.
Sarah Franklin trying to hit that flat and get a piece of the block. Misses that wide. 21 in red. Guchkaten shoring up serve receive for Wisconsin.
Service error. That gets Wisconsin to 15 points first. A 15-6 lead for the Badgers. Muff to Fitzpatrick. Tips it just past that Wisconsin block. We've seen how crafty she can be.
And she has to be. Undersized left side hitter. You've got a huge block in front of you. You have to find ways to score. That's just a little soft tip and some timing to score that ball just over the block.
Devin Robinson gets the call. Take two. Fitzpatrick dug up by Gigi. And a double called on Wisconsin.
And Florida had some opportunities but couldn't score but stayed in the rally.
Trying to feed Devin Robinson a lot. We've seen how she can take over a game. That one's going to be wide.
Well, I like that idea. I mean, she's hitting 7 for 18, hitting well over 300. That set was just a little bit inside.
So Kelly Sheffield,
their core is very experienced. They've got two veteran setters. They've got veterans on the right side. They've got size. And then Sarah Franklin returning, who led them in kills last year.
It's so great to see her back on the floor for Wisconsin. Ellie McKissick on the serve for the Gators. We love this sport too. How could you not? 10,323, a new attendance record in the O-Dome.
How about McKissick? Wow, that was a laser beam, and then the bottom just dropped out. That's a jump float serve executed perfectly. Watch her just pop it, and then the drop. Passer can't even get underneath that ball.
Franklin gets under that one. She'll get the swing off and grabs a piece of the Florida block to go along with it.
Both those left-siders for Wisconsin trying to work out of the negative hitting numbers they were hitting earlier. Sarah Franklin now at 0.
We're so glad to see Sarah Franklin on the court this season for Wisconsin. She had blood clots in her forearm in May of this year and was told she might not be able to play again. But fortunately, doctors were able to help her. She underwent a procedure, and she is back on the floor for the Badgers.
AC Fitzpatrick again from Florida on that left side, just a soft tip over the block, and it continues to drop. If you're Wisconsin, you need to take that away from her.
Making sure the floor is dry. And now Kennedy Martin steps up. MJ Hamill pushing it to Sarah Franklin. Trinity Adams underneath it. Hooch to Kent with a nice bump set over to Sarah Franklin, and she will terminate. It's hard to believe the summer that Sarah Franklin had. I mean, what a scary situation to go through.
Yeah, she did not know if she was done. Worst case scenario, she's done with volleyball. And it was just a matter of days finding out that she was 3 months away from coming back. And boy, was she relieved. But the support of this Wisconsin team was incredible. They were at the hospital every day. They were there for surgery. And I think it brought everybody closer together going through that type of an ordeal.
Absolutely. Anna Dixon can do it all for Florida.
And showing her versatility, going off 1 foot behind, something she worked on all summer with Alexis Stuckey.
Remember, this is the first time that Anna Dixon has played middle blocker since she was in the seventh grade, volunteered this summer to the Florida coaches, hey, I think I could work in the middle some if you wanted me to.
She just thought that that was an area where they could really use her, and she wants to be on the team for this Florida Gators.
What's the biggest change moving from the pens to the middle?
Well, so much. Just obviously the quick tempo of the offense, but moving side to side laterally, you have to close the block. And it's hard to go left to right. If you're on a left pin or a right pin, you just, it's one step, that's it. So that's a big adjustment defensively.
Hamill to Thomas Ilara. And Sophia Victoria just placed it in the back corner.
Florida knows what's open. The right back defender is cheating up. So in transition, you see Victoria go deep over her head for the kill. Florida's used that a lot today.
Thomas Ilara dug up. And a Smrek. Out, was it touched? No.
Kelly Sheffield is going to challenge it. Green card in hand.
So second challenge today for Wisconsin. They were correct in their first challenge, so still two challenges remaining.
I do not see a touch on that replay. Watch the right side, right hand of the middle blocker. That goes well inside her.
Yeah, I don't see a touch at the net. What about backing up the block?
I don't see any finger motion there.
The original call, no touch. So there obviously, there has to be an obvious touch in order for them to overturn it. And they did see one, so the point for Wisconsin.
Wow, I think I'm 0 for 2 today.
Yeah, it wasn't at the net, it was
in the backcourt, wow.
So 19-13, Wisconsin trying to get to 25. They have a nice lead here. Bluff to Victoria. Orzel lays out. Yes, Timmy Thomas, Ilara.
When we talked to Kelly Sheffield about this player, number 12 in red, she has not played in this kind of a match. She has not been in the NCAA tournament. These are new experiences for her.
Thomas Ilara was looking for a place that she could take that biomedical engineering degree from Northwestern and work in a teaching hospital. Wisconsin has that, and play volleyball. Wanted to have that NCAA tournament experience. Navy Okamore with the response.
Watch this ball by Muff in transition. Okamore goes way behind off 1 foot. Only one on one. Booth late to close that block.
556 hitting percentage for Okamore. Izzy Ashburn back to Thomas Ilara.
Izzy Ashburn isolates her there because the presence of Carter Booth, that holds the middle blocker for Florida.
Timmy will rotate out. Was an All-American, a second-team All-American last season at Northwestern. Four seasons for Northwestern. G just long from Gooch to Kent. Wisconsin has looked like a different team here in set number three, hitting 500. Florida was really serving them tough and getting them out of system a lot in the first two sets.
They were, and I feel like they're passing the ball much better in this third set.
Raising the tape, Carter Booth saves it. And Sarah Franklin will take that.
Booth off the dribbler, and then Ashburn pushes that ball fast out to Sarah Franklin. Look here to go high off the hands. Kennedy Martin there, but high and flat scores for Wisconsin.
Six kills for Franklin, seven digs to go along with it, and a service error.
Last time McKissick was on the back line, she had an ace.
Yeah, with a serve that was straight filth. Kennedy Martin.
Double contact, two Florida players fighting for that ball. Wisconsin looking a lot more relaxed in this set.
And Mary Wise and Florida will take a timeout here. Wisconsin needing 2 points to take set number three. Wisconsin looking for a fifth-ranked win of the season for the Gators. It would be their first win over a number one team since 2017 when they beat Texas. And they're going to call CeCe Crawford coming over and blocking the set.
That ball was passed pretty tight to the net. I'm not questioning Patty Rolfe anymore.
No.
She is always right. Setter has a chance to set that ball. You need to let her do that before going up and blocking it.
MJ Hamill to Smrek, dug up by Martin. Fitzpatrick coming to get it. Off the Wisconsin block.
AC Fitzpatrick going hard off the inside hand. That is not an easy kill, but working that ball to her advantage.
And Florida is going to make a substitution here. Gabrielle Essex is going to check in and replace Kennedy Muff, the setter. So that would leave Ellie McKissick and Trinity Adams.
Trinity Adams will run the offense. Because McKissick can't use her hands
right
in front of the 3-meter line.
Yeah, because she's wearing that Libero jersey. So McKissick will have to step in because Adams took the first contact. And Anna Dixon, Florida, finding a way.
What a substitution to make this play work in the defense. Off the hands of Wisconsin, and they're going to do it again.
They're doing this to get a bigger force at the net, right, Holly?
Basically a blocking substitution, yes.
Franklin, it is set point Wisconsin.
Senator Cedric Muff will come back into the court to run the offense.
Kennedy Martin out of the back row.
Yeah. Anna Dixon, wow. Number 24 in blue, the discipline getting out to close that block, pressing over the net. This is not easy to do. Look at her setup in the middle of the court. She knows she has to get over and close. Big press over the net. What a fantastic defensive play.
Second set point for Wisconsin in a set they must win. Point for Florida. As they call again, Wisconsin coming over.
I believe the call is that that ball is on the plane of the net. And the setter for Wisconsin is back row.
Yeah, that's the call for sure. You see MJ Hamill, who's the back row setter, going up, and that ball right on top of the net.
The front row.
Yeah, Anna Smrek being one of them, who's leading them right now with 8 kills, hitting 412.
But if you're Florida, you know the ball's going to Anna Smrek, so watch them possibly bunch read, which means staying inside to help slow down that middle attack from Smrek.
They're going to make the sub again, the blocking sub, where they bring in Gabrielle Essex. They replace Kennedy Muff. AC Fitzpatrick getting ready to serve. Wisconsin set point.
Who's setting in transition? That's the question. I'm guessing it's AC Fitzpatrick.
They do go to Anna Smrek. She tips over the block, and third time is a charm. Wisconsin gets set three. They force a fourth.
Set in transition. I like that.
Florida's All-American setter, Alexis Stuckey, was injured in set number two. She has come back out to the bench area on crutches with a brace on her right leg. So it has been Kennedy Muff who has stepped in her place in that third set, and again here in the fourth set. Sarah Franklin readjusting. Free ball back to Florida. Muff into the middle. Nady Okamore.
Not easy to do in transition. Run that high percentage attack to Okamore in the middle.
Okamore, a season high 6 kills for her. Her career high is 7.
She has been a bright spot, really opening up things offensively, going out to that right pin as well.
Sarah Franklin gets the kill, but how about the layout from Temi Thomas-Ilara?
She's been targeted in serve receive, but that time keeps it alive, and Franklin turns it down the line with power. She celebrates this one. Florida making it hard for her all day long. This one having success.
8th kill for Sarah Franklin, and now she will serve. Fitzpatrick wanting a touch. No, point Wisconsin.
McKissick telling her coach, please challenge, but I don't think they're going to use a challenge there.
Florida only has 1 challenge remaining. Unless we go to a 5th set, each team will get an additional challenge. No more than 2. Just a bit wide for Sarah Franklin's serve.
Anna Dixon back on the court in the front row for the Gators. She has been a spark defensively.
She's been a spark with her serve, with her blocking, with some big swings.
Her defense, even in the backcourt.
Yes. Franklin with the pass. They get to run Smrek. Thomas-Ilara.
Kennedy Muff defensively supposed to be on that right line. She thought that ball was wide, but Wisconsin tags it. Wisconsin working in transition. Look at Thomas Alara tag it right on the line.
Timmy Thomas Alara, she was the go-to at Northwestern. First in the Big Ten last year in total kills with 502.
That ball mishit by Anna Smrek. Gets away from her.
Kennedy Martin, service error.
Florida trying to get that ball to Temi Thomas Alara, missing that wide, but going that line to line right at her.
So Wisconsin makes that 6-2 sub. Izzy Ashburn comes in. One of two setters that Wisconsin uses along with Devin Robinson. A back set to Anna Dixon. Yulia Orzol, a great dig down the line. Thomas Alara.
That's her best swing of the match. Wisconsin needs her, and in transition, she gets to this ball. Starts with a fantastic Orzol dig, and then look at Alara, Thomas Alara, get her feet to that ball and turn it sharp.
You see what kind of powerful punch she can pack. Three ball back to the Badgers. Ashburn to Robinson. Trinity Adams on the dig. And AC Fitzpatrick is just wide.
Trinity Adams, strong dig in that right back position, but miscue there. Florida getting opportunities to score because of their defense, though.
Their defense has been so scrappy all match. Career ace leader at Wisconsin, Izzy Ashburn, one of the captains as well.
AC Fitzpatrick just going for it. Gigantic block in front of her, and she gets a piece of it.
You know, Mary Wise told us AC has grown up a lot since she arrived before last season, spent her first 2 years playing at Penn State, and she's embraced the idea that she needs to be a point scorer. We talked about how she's undersized, so she's got to have a bigger toolkit, and now she knows when to use those different shots.
Timing, decision making, and yes, she's been really good. I mean, she's had a huge block in front of her all night, so that flat ball, the soft tip over the middle, has scored as well for her.
Nine kills for Fitzpatrick as she's rotated out right now. You know, we were talking before this fourth set start, as you see Gigi Guchtikin step back. How much of an impact that she had coming into this match in the third set?
She was an impact for sure because she shored up the serve receive. Passed well and allowed Wisconsin to hit for high numbers.
Guchtikin was the main libero last season, and the libero coming in to this year, Yulia Orzol, this is just her sixth start in that libero jersey. Victoria not afraid of Wisconsin's block.
Sophia Victoria Power pushes that ball down. Little space between the two blockers. We call that attacking the seam. How about Muff pushing that ball out? There's just a little bit of space, and she takes it.
Roll shot from Sarah Franklin. Anna Dixon back row, dug up by Orzol. Nady Orkamore with the stop!
Nettie Okamore in transition, patrolling the net for Florida. Anna Dixon out of the back row. What a dig by Orzel. And then look at Okamura with her left hand shut down that angle.
Good pass from Gouchtekin. Sarah Franklin will take a swing like that all day.
Sarah Franklin has so much range as an offensive attacker, but last three or four swings, turning it down that line, and I feel like Florida's daring her to do that.
You know, Kelly Sheffield talked to us about when Sarah Franklin arrived last season. It's a different role because at Michigan State, you know, she was getting almost every ball, and now she has help around her and so many different weapons. Coming over. Credit to Sarah.
Sarah Franklin all over that, but Orzel putting the service pressure on Florida, and that's what sets up Sarah Franklin at the net. This is a tough rotation right now with Muff, the setter for Florida, in the front row and only two front row attackers. They want to get out of this rotation.
And Nady Okamura is going to do that for them. Kennedy Muff steps back to serve. She had to come into the match. This is just her fourth set of the season. She'll take that. Yes, please.
She's hitting that serve with some pace. It's flat, it's moving, and that's causing Wisconsin some problems.
Six aces for the Gators. Wisconsin's going to save it. Izzy Ashburn and Devin Robinson in to the back line. Florida within one.
Wisconsin all out effort defensively to stay in that rally. Watch this little ball. One arm stab by Ashburn, and then Wisconsin doing all they can to stay in it, and Florida still able to score in the next swing.
That sails on Kennedy Muff.
Anna Smrek back on the court for Wisconsin.
And number 14 in red, she has 9 kills, hitting 333.
Wow.
MJ Hamill, my goodness.
Yes, that's flat and clean. You call it a fleen serve, and wow. If you hit it right, the ball just drops. I like this angle right here. You can see the hand contact, no spin on the ball, and the movement takes it down and away from that passer.
Just the second ace today for the Badgers. Nady Okamura, you can tell she's comfortable with Kennedy Muff.
8 kills, 0 errors on 12 swings. She is having the match of her career. The connection is there, nice, high, flat location.
She came into the match with just 5 total kills on the season. Had only played in 13 sets before today. Sarah Franklin tags the back line.
Sarah Franklin saw an opening and just went, took a little pace off of it, finds the open floor.
Wisconsin laying out all over to keep the ball from hitting the ground. MJ Hamill digging Martin. Thomas Ilara. Point for Florida.
MJ Hamill, the setter for Wisconsin, had 2 incredible digs, but Okamura too much in the defensive transition blocking category.
Unfortunately, if you're Florida, she rotates out.
True. But now Kennedy Martin's in the front row with Anna Dixon.
8 kills, 5 blocks for Nady Okamore. Here comes Martin. Point Wisconsin.
Ball set a little inside for Martin in transition. Runs out of angle to attack.
Fitzpatrick dug by Crawford. MJ Hamill back to Anna Smrek. Free ball for the Badgers. You give it to Carter Booth.
MJ Hamill to Carter Booth. Perfect transition, high percentage kill out of the middle. Wisconsin 15-11. Has not had a kill in the set. And she's the go-to player for Florida. I think they want to get her the ball more. Down by 4.
Absolutely. She averages over 4.5 kills per set. Casey Fitzpatrick rejected.
Wisconsin serving the left side of the court, and the pass keeps pulling the setter that direction, so it's hard to get Kennedy Martin all the way. You call it a long string set, harder to keep her in system.
Kennedy Martin, number 18 in blue for the Gators. That looks good.
And Muff that time going to Dixon out of the middle. Blockers cheating towards the right side, and then Dixon able to score.
6 kills for Anna Dixon, no errors. Put that along with 3 service aces, 4 digs, and 3 blocks. It's a full stat line for Dixon. MJ Hamill setting up Anna Smrek.
That one got away from Anna Smrek, trying to go down that line. Doesn't make good hand contact, and the ball sails.
Laura. Martin in the back row. Orzel hustles to save it. Fitzpatrick comes right back at her off of Carter Booth.
That's the biggest block in the country right there. Carter Booth at 6'7". Anna Smrek at 6'9" on the right side of your screen. That is a gigantic block.
Whew.
And terrifying to play against.
And AC Fitzpatrick, an undersized outside hitter, listed at 5'11".
I think any hitter would have nightmares about that block.
I'm not a hitter, and I still have nightmares about it.
Me too. But if you're playing a block that size, you know what you do? You set away. There's a smaller blocker over on the other side at 6'1", 6'2". You set that way.
Carter Booth, 5 kills, 5 blocks. Wisconsin has 16 blocks. Florida is actually out-blocking them, 8-6. Ashburn had to set it with one hand, wide.
What a set by Ashburn to hustle and get Booth in a position to score, just pushed wide. Carter Booth understood the assignment, front row setter, and she is all over that defensively. A lot of times blockers will relax on the setter when she's front row. Booth way over the net for Wisconsin. Watch this play close to the net. Muff trying to attack it back, but Booth way over the net.
Dixon dug up by Ashburn. Franklin will take it. Martin in the back row. Gooch to Kent. To Devin Robinson. McKissick tries Sophia Victoria. Sarah Franklin with the tip. Wow! Straight down to the floor. It may have even surprised Sarah Franklin herself.
Sarah Franklin got there. The ball was inside, and she was able to hit it sharper than anybody else on the court thought she could. What a rally. We saw both teams make some fantastic defensive plays, but Dixon not far enough over in the angle, and Franklin's pretty fired up about it.
Look at her reaction. 12 kills for Sarah Franklin to lead all attackers in this match.
Available out of the back row down the middle.
Sophia Victoria.
Florida has worked all spring since January, pushing the pace of their offense, and you see it pay off there.
Back on the Wisconsin side, Booth knew it. And that turned too much by Victoria.
The timing was a tiny bit off. Sophia Victoria was on her way down and could not get a piece of the block on that swing.
Nadie Okemor coming around. You can see the look in her eye.
She already had her season high, but she continues to impress. And not just offensively. She's been incredible blocking in transition. Look at her go off the hands of the inside blocker.
9 kills, no errors. A career high for her. Oh, Devin Robinson. Spicy.
We know she can be dangerous offensively there, getting on top of that ball quick for Wisconsin.
Hamel to Franklin. Okemor just tipping over the block.
Kennedy Muff knows to get the ball to her hot hitter. If you have a hitter like Okemor on fire, you want to get her to the ball. Look at her drive offensively to put herself in a position to score. She is on fire.
Nadie Okemor tied for the team lead with 10 kills now, adding to that career high. Again, she had 5 kills on the season coming into this match. Anna Smrek elevating.
That's a high contact point. When you've got a 6'9" attacker, she's way over the net. Caught a piece of the tape, but she hit that pretty sharp angle.
Smrek into double figures now. Sarah Franklin leading Wisconsin with 12, Smrek with 10. Going over, boom! Clean it up, Anna Smrek.
Wisconsin has really turned it around from the service line. They picked it up, serving the seam between those two passers, and then Anna Smrek cleans it up at the net.
Florida will take a timeout here. Wisconsin 2 points away from forcing a 5th set. So Florida with no more timeouts in this set. Sarah Franklin and Wisconsin needing 2 more points to force a 5th. AC Fitzpatrick, she's done that several times tonight.
She has the Midas touch. We've seen her do it over the middle successfully. This time she goes over the line. Kennedy Muff pushes that ball to the left antenna, and the right defender is back trying to dig that hard line ball, and that's why it's so hard to get the short ball over the block.
Fitzpatrick now one of three Florida Gators in double figures. That puts her at 10 kills.
Ellie McKissick to serve the lead.
Anna Smrek. Pancake by Julia Orzel. Off of the block goes AC.
Julia Orzel again, this is her third pancake, slides under this ball to keep it alive. But look at AC Fitzpatrick on the left side of your screen work to get outside and transition and kill that ball.
And Wisconsin takes a timeout. 23-20, it was 23-18.
Crawford, Smrek, and Thomas Alara in the front row for Wisconsin. Watch them try and match up Smrek on the right side or to attack AC Fitzpatrick, the smallest blocker in the front row for Florida.
Timmy Thomas, Alara. Take two, off hands. Set point, Wisconsin.
And if you're Florida right now, you want to avoid Booth and Smrek on the right side and set Kennedy Martin on the left side, who's still looking for her first kill in the set.
Service error, second set point for Wisconsin.
Florida's doing it again, blocking sub.
At number 10 in blue, Gabrielle Essex checks in. So they take Kennedy Muff out. They have Trinity Adams, who can be that setter on the floor. Smrek. Long. Third set point coming for the Badgers.
And it pays off again, that blocking sub. I love it.
Timeout, Wisconsin.
If you're looking at matchups for Wisconsin, you want Smrek on the right side pin attacking against AC Fitzpatrick, the smallest blocker on the floor.
Yeah, that's Smrek, who's 6'9", against 5'11", AC Fitzpatrick. Hamill runs Smrek in front of her. Wisconsin seals the set, and we're going five. Wouldn't have it any other way between two of the top three teams in the nation. We will play to 15 points. You have to win by two. They'll switch sides after one team reaches 8 points. Things go a lot faster in the fifth set. There's even less room for error.
Essex in the front row right now for Florida. She was a blocking sub at the end of the last two sets, but starting in the match now.
It's number 10 in blue for the Gators. Wisconsin will serve. MJ Hamill. Anna Dixon. Thomas Alara with a nice dig. Kennedy Martin is blocked. CeCe Crawford and Anna Smrek.
And that was a non-setter putting that ball up to Kennedy Martin on the left side, but you probably want to set away from 6'9 Anna Smrek, who doesn't have to move much to set up that block for Wisconsin.
Kennedy Martin did not have a kill in the fourth set. She averages 4.6 kills per set. Dixon tries to tip, Franklin sends it back. Martin with the easy roll, she will take it.
Wow, MJ Hamill was there, easy for Wisconsin, just caught the tape and changed direction, surprised her a little bit.
Franklin handles it well. She gets the opportunity to swing. Kennedy Muff in the middle to Gabrielle Essex. Free ball to the Badgers. Franklin, roll shot. Trinity Adams. Oh, yes! Sophia Victoria places it in the corner.
That offensive push play on the left side, deep down the line, has been working for Florida all match long. You see the setter right back, defensive player, scoot up, and that catches the line.
One-handed save from Victoria. Orja will bump set CeCe Crawford. Gators up two.
We're seeing arms flying. Look at Victoria slide under this ball to keep it alive, and then Kennedy Martin down balls it. That one wide in transition from Wisconsin.
Anna Smrek.
There's the high percentage attack that Wisconsin wants to use when they can pass that ball well. Smrek one-on-one in the middle is tough to stop.
13 kills now to lead the Badgers, hitting 300, also five blocks to go along with that. Thomas Alara.
That ball hit the antenna. Thomas Alara trying to turn it down the line, gets a piece of the antenna, and Florida now up 4-2.
Again, we're going to only 15 points here in the third, in the fifth set.
Watch Wisconsin try and get Smrek the ball again.
There they go. Florida was ready. That swing long from Sophia Victoria. Point Wisconsin.
Florida able to dig it but not transition it back.
Jocelyn Boyer has come in. She will serve for the Badgers.
That's a big serve.
Wow.
And a tough roll to step into off the bench coming in with an ace.
Ties it at four. Third ace today for Wisconsin. Kennedy Martin.
The block had moved in to take the line away from Martin, and she's able to swing that super sharp inside. Watch Kennedy Martin on the right side of your screen Block gets it in front of her, allowing her to swing sharp angle.
Kennedy Martin's name up there in the running for sure for the National Freshman of the Year. Still so much season left to be played, but she has been fantastic for Florida so far through nine matches. Anna Smrek, there you go.
Anna Smrek again over the top using her size, and the left side player in the front row picked up that ball, which forces Wisconsin to go to the right side, but that's in their favor.
So Wisconsin hits that double sub. They run that 6-2 offense, so two setters. The setter always in the back row. So a new setter, Izzy Ashburn, back to serve. And a new right side up there, Devin Robinson. Muff tried to get crafty. Devin Robinson at 9 kills today.
It looks like Florida flipped their middles in the lineup. Look at that dig by Ashburn to keep it alive, and then Robinson deep cross in transition for Wisconsin. Oakmore off the blocker's hands, out of bounds. Whole Wisconsin team telling their coach to challenge that might have hit Oakmore on the way out.
Wisconsin does have two challenges, so they'll use one here. You get an additional challenge in the fifth set, but you can't have more than two.
Ooh, see that block. Looks like a little limbo, pulling that shoulder down. I do not see a touch, do you?
So close to her shoulder.
Ooh.
Maybe right there?
Well, the ball has spin off it already, so it's hard to see if it doesn't change directions.
The original call was no touch, and the point was awarded to Florida.
It has to be definitive to overturn it. I did not see anything. Looks like some distance between shoulder and ball. That's definitely a pretty good look at it.
And we have a decision. There was not enough evidence to overturn that call. So they will stick with the original call on the floor, which was no touch and a point for Florida. We are tied at 6. Going to 15. A double.
Tough serve by Florida creates that error by Wisconsin. I'll tell you, Mary Wise and Dave Booz are playing with their lineup. They've got Anna Dixon in the front row. Looks like she's playing left side to create a bigger block versus Wisconsin.
And remember, most of her collegiate career, she has been a pen hitter. Service error, point for the Badgers.
The fact that Florida can pop into different lineups with different players in different positions and handle, it's pretty impressive, especially on this stage against the number one team in the country.
Buchtigan in to serve for Wisconsin, tied at 7. Outside to Anna Dixon, set her anywhere. Four to the first to 8.
Anna Dixon's a leader. She stepped up, took the challenge of changing positions. She's very comfortable hitting on that pin, gets a really important kill for Florida.
So we switch sides and step aside for just a moment. First loss of the season. Franklin dug by Martin. There's Dixon. Still keeping her on that left pin. Franklin roll shot. Shoved down by Devin Robinson.
Carter Booth, 52 in red. Defensive touch. Watch this here. Working defensively, getting off defensive touch, and then Devin Robinson, her teammate, slam dunks it down in the middle.
Sick with the bump set to Dixon. It hits the scoreboard, still playable because it stayed on Wisconsin's side of the net. That's a point for Florida.
And guess who just stepped in and crushed that ball in transition? Anna Dixon.
Mary Wise calling for a sub. They will sub out Kennedy Muff and bring in AC Fitzpatrick.
So we have another defensive situation where you're going to see Emily Kanan go to right back and set in transition. Florida looking for stops on with their defense.
Monster serve, it results in an overpass and a point. Absolutely crushed it.
AC Fitzpatrick has been crushing her jump serve, and the pace off the platform of the passer makes it travel over the net, where Essex, even though she doesn't get a hold of it, that one gets away from Wisconsin. The energy in this building is incredible right now.
10,000 plus will do that. And Wisconsin takes a timeout. Florida 5 points away from beating the number one team in the nation.
Of assignments.
We have seen, though, how Wisconsin can come out of a timeout. They call that timeout. They're so quick to refocus and settle back down.
They are, but Florida's relentless.
Yeah.
Again, no setter on the floor for Florida. They are scheming, but Emily Kanan will set in transition, number 7 in blue.
Buchtigan, that was a great pass. It was a huge serve, and she handled it so well so they could run CeCe Crawford.
High percentage one-on-one in the middle, tags the line. That's a big-time side out right there for Wisconsin.
Florida has brought Kennedy Muff back onto the floor, so their setter is back. Dixon on the right side, attacking error, and Wisconsin ties it at 10.
Looked like Dixon was trying to get some hands going flat cross court, but missed.
2 points out of the timeout for Wisconsin, and now Florida will take a timeout.
A lot of strategy going back and forth, trying to ice the server, trying to get your team focused on a big stop.
Because it is a race to 15 points right now. You have to win by 2. Three, Essex in the middle. Campbell to Sarah Franklin. Back line, got it.
Big time transition swing right there by Franklin, catching the back line. Gulchtekin gets under, lifts that ball for her setter, and then Franklin finding that deep cross ball.
First lead for Wisconsin since it was 6-5 here in the fifth set. And a miscommunication. Emily Kanan pulled up at the last minute, and Ellie McKissick threw her hands up. Timeout, Florida.
But credit the server, MJ Hamill. That ball floated high and caught the passer in an uncomfortable spot.
Wisconsin bringing that tough serve. They're up by two, 3 points away from staying undefeated on the season.
Florida has been passing the ball great all day today. Just a breakdown there at a bad time.
MJ Hamill had an ace before the timeout. She steps back once again for Wisconsin. Smrek. Kennedy Martin, it's long, 13-10 Wisconsin.
Kennedy Martin was in such a strong offensive rhythm early. Feel like she's not in the same spot. They've gone away from her.
Dixon wanted that. I mean, the firepower down the line.
Anna Dixon, heavy arm for Florida. Caught the defender, left back Ulche Gulchtekin, one of the best defenders for Wisconsin.
Oh, takes it to the face. Gulchtekin still in the match for Wisconsin. Point Badgers.
Anna Smrek yelling at her team. She wants the ball with the match on the line. Put that ball in a really nice location for Kennedy Martin, who gets a much needed kill for Florida. Sophia Victoria, good pass, match on the line, and then Kennedy Martin, sharp cross court.
Wisconsin will take its final timeout, second match point for the Badgers on the way.
Florida needs a stop. Right now, they're all focused on what they're going to do defensively. We might look for another defensive sub. We've seen them use that when the match is on the line.
Match point, Wisconsin.
Deep cross court. Good things happen when you get this ball deep. It's in the seam between two passers. Gets away from Wurzel.
A third match point. Hamill to Smrek. Wisconsin at the top and still undefeated. A heck of a match in Gainesville today, but the number one team in the nation holds strong.
Florida has a lot to be proud of, tons of adversity, and they were able to fight under really tough circumstances.
Wisconsin, a fifth win over a ranked opponent, just their second win all time against the Florida Gators. What impressed you the most today about how the Badgers got it done?
Well, their backs were against the wall. They were out of sorts, and they found a way. This is a veteran team.
Yeah, see, awesome.